will start the economic zoology. Economic zoology means utilizing the animal in economic purposes or getting the benefit from the animals for the profession. You will not believe the animal or utilizing the animal for the purpose of this zoology. It is very beneficial, and it gives the large intensives means सबसे ज्यादा इकोनॉमिक जो है इट इज रियली एनिमल्स ओनली टू रियर एंड केयर अबाउट देम. सो टुडे लाइकवाइज मेनी एनिमल्स आर देयर. वी ऑल आर गोइंग टू लर्न. फर्स्ट वी विल बी टॉकिंग अबाउट द एपिकल्चर, देन वी विल बी टॉकिंग अबाउट. एम आई क्लियरली ऑडिबल स्टूडेंट?
नो मैम,
माई वॉइस इज क्रैकिंग.
मैम योर वॉइस इज स्लो.
ओके, एम आई ऑडिबल नाउ? यस. यस, माई वॉइस इज क्लियर नाउ?
यस मैम.
ओके. सो वेन वी टॉक अबाउट द इकोनॉमिक जुअलॉजी, वी विल बी टॉकिंग अबाउट द एपी कल्चर, यूज ऑफ द एपीस, दैट इज द बीज, फॉर गेटिंग द बेनिफिट. फर्स्ट वी विल बी टॉकिंग अबाउट द एपी कल्चर ओनली. देर आर मैनी यूजफुल एनिमल्स, स्पेशली द इंसेक्ट्स, दे हेल्प इन दैट. लाइक वी हैव एपी कल्चर, सेरी कल्चर, लैक कल्चर, बट in your syllabus only APs, that is the honey bees are only given. But likewise honey bees, we have many other useful insects, those who are contributing for the economic purpose. Then we have many other animals, those who all are very much useful, like earthworms. They are contributing for the vermiculture, and then we will be talking about the dairy sciences, that how the dairy processing happens, then how much milk is effective. And we know that now dairy and dairy products have the good demand because of its nutritional value. So these are about the syllabus, but apart from that, many other industries, they are totally relying on the animals. So really zoology or the animal husbandry have a very good scope into the future. So when we say like other animals, say example the woolen industry, it is also depend good quality wool. This we are getting from the sheep, good breeds, especially that Kashmiri shawl and all, which are very costly. We are getting it from the animals. Then silk, we are depend on the animal, good quality silk. Synthetic is also available, but the good quality silk sari, if you will just wrap it, you can just cover it into the small matchbox. It is that level soft. You can imagine that level it can hold. Then many other animals are there that they are contributing, like edible animals, fish. Fish culture a very great demand into the market. Then we have the other cultures, like we have the goat culture and other eating edible animals. So in short, zoology have a very good economic importance. That means the animal have a very good economic importance. So we will be learning only three as part of your syllabus. First we will be talking about the AP culture. Now see, culture, when we say the term culture, it means rearing and caring animal for the purpose of the economic use. So when we talk about rearing and caring animals, that means these are not the pet animal that for love we are caring or rearing them. These are the animals, these are the useful animals. We are rearing and caring them for getting the economic use, or you can say simply making the money. So first, when we talk about the apiculture, So it is the applied branch of entomology. Note down the term entomology. It can be asked into the MCQ that apiculture is related to the dash branch. So the entomology means study of insects. Entomology, study of the useful insect. Here all the insect like pest and all everything will come in under the study of the entomology. It is the study of insect. So now here when we talk about the apiculture, as I told you that the culture, the term itself means rearing and caring. So when we say the apiculture, so it means the rearing of the honeybees to obtain the money from it, or you can say to make money. So here when we are making money from it, so definitely we need to yield the good quality of the honey, and we should maintain, we should culture them. This is the natural beehive. Now see, natural hive and the artificial hive, both are available, both are used for harvesting honey and the other important economic material from it. So first we will be talking about what are the method, traditional and indigenous method. In the traditional method, oldest method, they used to obtain it honey and the wax. Now here they were not using the mankind for, just a minute, Haji, go outside. In the older time or the indigenous period, the people used to get the honey from the natural beehive only. Nowadays, the artificial beehives are been made, and they are used. Now, see, when we want to get the good money from any business, what we will do? We will invest some money in that so that we can have a proper structure so that we can get the better benefit. So for that particular reason, the such type of artificial beehives also make. First, we will be talking about the natural hive, and thereafter we will be talking about the artificial beehive. In the traditional period of the time, they used to construct the natural hive only, and they never used to construct. They used to give the space. They used to grow the flower and all so that they can get for the purpose of the pollination, for getting nectar. Bee used to locate to that particular area, and they used to build their own hive over there. So this natural hives usually hangs vertically downwards, and the cell are present horizontal into the position. When we talk about the natural beehive, it has the various cell, and it is first of all built from the worker bees. Now when we will study about the social life of the honeybee, you will come to know that all the population of honeybee, it is categorized as the worker. First of all, queen, the main, you can say main player of the beehive, or you can say the commander is the queen, and thereafter drones, then worker. So this worker, they are doing everything. They are in caring, building, then protection. Everything is done by collecting nectar. Everything, every function is been done by the worker only. So these poor worker bees, they are only building this beautiful beehive by using the wax and the propolis. Propolis is a very special substance. It is maybe red or brown resinous substance which is collected by the honeybee from the tree buds. So from there they are collecting and they are building. This beehive is very much beautiful in architecture. It has the various compartment. As you can see here, they have the storage cell. Now see, these storage cells, they are building at the top so that whenever they are collecting the pollen, these pollen cells are actually the cells which are present on the top, or you can say where they can access and the store bees. Now here they will be making such type of cells at the margin of the comb. Here they will be storing the honey as well as the pollen. Now pollen that they will be converting it into the honey by themselves. I'm sorry, students. Thereafter you will be finding the brood cells. Now these brood cells for the new babies of the family, and here they will be properly covering and caring. Now see, whenever any attack will be happening, so there are chances that the bottom part will be, or you can say the lower part of the hive will be less affected, and that will be more ventilated. So because this beehive, natural beehive, is kept vertically, so for that particular reason, this cells or brood cells, they are kept at the bottom or the lower side of the beehive, where the broods, or you can say the new babies, they have their five different instars, various stages are there. They are getting up or growing up here. Then you will be observing the drone cells are there. So these drone cells, where the young stages of drones are reared, and thereafter there are the queen cells, where the larvae developing into the queen will be reared. Now if you will observe the queen cells, so these are the largest than the other. Adult move on the surface area of the comb, as they do not have any separate chamber. Earlier human beings, they used to harvest the honey by damaging the comb. Simply they used to do some fire or something so that all the adult honey will be moved out, and they used to simply extrude the hive honey from the beehive. But after that, because of such crude method, they will be getting honey and wax also, but this will kill so many little instars or the brood which are present inside. Now if we will talk about one honey beehive, so that particular beehive is nothing but one entire family, or better word can be used as a colony. And this particular colony consists of one queen, and then there may be 300 drones, 25,000 older worker bees, and foragers bee are approximately 25,000 young worker bees in the hive. So these rear the brood, which consists of approximate 6,000 eggs and 9,000 young larvae and 2,000 older larvae. All these are packed, sealed into the cell. So see, all this will be losing their homes, approximate so many individual of the family, if simply the crude method of extruding the honey from natural hive is done. If you will observe this brood cell, so you will find that they do not require any special attention except keeping them into the proper warmth and sealing. So their brood cells, they are properly packed with the required food for the bees brood, and they are kept sealed. Now when we talk about advantages and disadvantages of traditional apiculture, so advantage is that two species of wild honeybees, Apis sirena and Apis dorsata, they are managed by the traditional technique only. Traditional apiculture is very easy to perform because no special techniques are required to construct the beehive. Everything is done by the honey. Very less capital investment is required, right? Because see, actually no investment is required for preparing the beehive. Honey bee itself is constructing the beehive. She herself is doing rearing, caring. Everything is done by. Only the thing is that they used to grow some flower and all. Traditional apiculture is an ideal, eco-friendly, and no land-based rural enterprises, which they do not require any tax on the farm resource, and they provide the sustainable livelihood to the rural people. Wild species used into the traditional apiculture are more resistant to the pest and disease. They are not getting attacked from because they are staying into their own wild environment. So chances of getting pest and disease is extremely low. They are less prone to be attacked by the pine marten and other enemies because of the wall of this hive. They lie about 2 to 2.5 meter above the ground, and they log hives into the hung under the leaves from the houses. Bee colonies migrate less frequently from the traditional hive due to the fewer disturbance by the beekeeper, and in the modern method, the disturbance is extremely high. So for that particular reason, the natural beehive is very ideal place for the bee to stay. But there are certain disadvantages of the traditional apiculture also. Whatever honey produced by this method is very much impure, because I told you simply what they are doing. They are just squeezing this particular beehive and they are extracting the honey. So for that particular reason, whatever things are present into the comb, that everything will come. It may be the dead body of the broods or something. So for that particular reason, they will not be able to fetch a good price. Lots of contamination is there, like brood extracts might be there, part of bee bodies, they may be debris of the hive, and you will find that it ferments very quickly because of all such contamination. You cannot keep it for the longer period of time. There are increased chances of queen loss during the honey harvesting. It is very difficult to inspect the colonies thoroughly and maintain them properly. You cannot detect that, yes, definitely you have grown few of the plants which are favorite of the honeybee, and definitely they will come and they will settle, and they will, because you have to depend on the bee. So it is not necessary that you will be getting it. Management with traditional technique brings the limitation for beekeeper, particularly for the operations such as uniting, dividing various castes of honeybee, rearing of the queen, and control of worker. Everything is not at all possible. Beekeeping may be affected by the adverse weather and the climatical condition that may result into the reduced income from the beekeeper. Race improvement program cannot be applied into the traditional apiculture because there is no such advancement into the method. Now we will be talking about the modern method of the beekeeping. When we talk about the modern beehive, so these are constructed by intervention of the man. Here the honeybees are provided with the wooden box, and this wooden box is called as the movable frame hive. It could be single walled or it may be the double walled, depends on the suitability of the environment condition. On the basis of the environment condition, this type of wooden box are been prepared. So a length stock hive is a typically single walled wooden box. It consists of the bottom board at the base on the which bottom box is present. This is called as the brood chamber. Now honeybee enters into the brood chamber through an inlet, and this particular side will be called as the bee entrance. Here, inlet is you can see. So these frames can be separated from the hive for the inspection of the honey extraction, as I have shown one separated sheet here. So all these frames can be extracted to observe whether the hive is ready or not. The What about the colony? And the best about this is here there will not be any damage to the comb. Simply you can extract out all such type of the chamber. There is a gap of the specific distance between two frame, and this gap is called as the bee space. This bee space serves as a passage for the movement of the bees. There is an additional chamber above the brood chamber that is called as the super chamber. Here. here. This is meant for the purpose of the honey storage. A queen bee is never allowed to enter in this chamber. To prevent queen entering from this particular chamber, a frame is fitted between these two, and this frame is made up of the metallic wire net with the gap of 0.15 inches, and that is known as the queen excluder. That means this is going to prevent, this is the metal frame, and this metal frame will prevent the queen to enter into the honey chamber. And a crown board for inner cover is placed on the super chamber. A top cover is placed over the inner cover that may be flat or it may be sloping also. So this thing can be preventing the entire honey beehive. Now there are various bees which are used into the apiculture. Apis dorsata is there, Apis bingami, then Apis brerigula is there, then Apis laboriza, Apis mellifera, Apis sirenia indica, Apis nigrosinata, Apis nulensia, many are there. So here there is a very much importance of when you are doing the artificial beehive. So you need to select the flora and bees for the apiculture. You must be aware that which bees you are going to use, and that particular bees requires which type of the plant. So that honey plants must be selected, the suited honey plants must be selected so that they can get the good quality of the honey out of that. So when we talk about the advantages, first of all, there are many advantages of economic point of view. It is very much advantageous. Modern apiculture, like it will give the pure quality. So scientific beekeeping, actually it is started in the year 1851 with the discovery of the movable frame hive by an American L.L. Langstroth. Students remember this name, that can be asked into the MCQ type of the question, that American L.L. Langstroth has discovered this movable beehive. Prior to this, beekeeping method were very crude, and quantity of whatever honey is harvested was actually quarter what we are obtaining today. So these native bees, which are adhered to the tropical nature, that can produce 2 to 6 kilograms of the honey per year, while the European bees, they can yield approximate 50 kg of the honey per year. All beehives these are used into the industry are made up of the wooden boxes, removable frame of the combs, and all the parts are interchangeable within the apiary. So pure honey can be produced into the large quantity with the which fetches the good price in the market, because it will have the less impurities. Hives can be protected from the enemies, pest and disease by use of various type of the pesticides. Under adverse environment condition also, this beehive can be shifted from the one place to the another place, because this is movable. So chances of losing a colony is very rare. You can provide that colony a new place by moving it to the new place. Also, we can do the race improvement program because of availability of, we can access the genetically modified new species of the bees here. But there are certain disadvantages also, like in absence of flowering vegetation, bee colonies have to be provided with the sugar syrup for their survival. Indiscriminate use of pesticides on crop may cause heavy loss of colonies, killing the bees and reducing the yield. Due to repeated exposure to the pesticides, honeybee loses their natural resistance against the disease. Modern apiculture practices, cost intensive, are very, they require fund and a special infrastructure for proper management. After seasonal harvesting of honey from modern hives, transportation of bee box and equipment to new location is very much costly, and really, it is very time consuming to locate the new bees into that particular area. Beekeeper cannot afford to grow bee flora exclusively for honeybees. They face colony migration constriction due to the lack of bee flora. There are many pest and bee enemies like wax moth, wasp, black ants, then bee eater, king crow. So there are causing various type of diseases to the honey, and this cause the colony destruction. So there are various prevention and the control measure. We should be very much careful for the site selection, and temporary relocation can be done if such type of pests are harming the colony. So relocation of the apiaries should be done until and unless the migration period of the bird is over, because these birds, they are just becoming the pest over such bees. Predatory birds can be scared away by making noise, or maybe by beating the drums by a single shot and by using the red reflective ribbons around the apiary. Apiary site should be located far away from the birds' perching objects, such as telephone wires, electric poles, and building trees, because all such things, they are calling the birds. So we should prevent the bees from the bird. There are various diseases of the honeybee which are causing directly disease to the honeybee, like American foul bird disease, that is AFB. Then European foul bird disease is there, chalkbrood disease is there, nosemia disease. There are various viral diseases also happening to the honeybees, sacbrood disease is there. So all such diseases, they are affecting the quality of the honey, because if bees affected, they will not produce the bees honey properly. Now, when we talk about just a minute, Shadab, Shadab. Now, what is the beekeeping study industry's present status? Actually, Indian economy is largely depend on the agriculture, so it requires the high initial investment. So farmer, they always prefer beekeeping as important subsidy occupation, which provides the high return, because honey is very costly. Like honey, royal jelly, bee wax, bee venom, propolis, all these are very costly materials. So and moreover that this honeybee, they enable the efficient pollination of the crops, so they can act as a biosensor for monitoring the health of the environment. So for that particular reason, commercially it is appreciated by the Indian farmer, and it's initiated in the Travancore in 1917 and Mysore in 1925. In the recommendations of the Royal Commission of the Agriculture 1928 for the developing cottage industry, it gives a boost to beekeeping into the rural states like Tamil Nadu, Punjab, and UP. In the year 1938 to 39, Beekeeper of the India, they recognized and founded All India Beekeeper Association. Then afterward also Indian Council of the Agricultural Research, ICAR, that establishes the first beekeeping research station into the Punjab in the year 1945, and 6 years later at the Coimbatore into the Tamil Nadu. Even in 1980 also, ICAR, they started All India Coordinated Project on the Honeybee Research and Training. This all presented as the 8th center throughout the country. So when all such efforts are being made, lots of honey production is done by such method, that is the modern method. If you will count only in India, so India produce about 4,000 metric tons of honey, which constitute about 2/3 of the honey which is produced throughout. Honey is very commercially important object, which is fetches an average price of 350 per kg. Actually, this is the this cost is for the farmer, मतलब approximate 350, but when you will go and buy honey, you know what is the cost, approximate more than 500 per kg it is. Country exports fetches approximate 60 million during the 2004 and 5 alone. So you can imagine that amount is really very good, but this data I am giving of year 2004 and 5, now it is increasing day by day. Honey consumption per capita is highest into the European country, where annual per capita exceeds 1 kilogram compared to the India and China, which is about 2 to 3 grams. Beekeeping covers 4,000 villages and it provides the complete. It gives employment to many people. Approximately 3 lakh people are getting employment because in the rural area because of this beekeeping. There is a further potential to boost the industry by increasing about 120 million bee colonies, which can provide self-employment to more than 7 million rural people. Research efforts are made to improve and boost such type of industry because of demand of the honeybee for doing the cross-pollination and all. Lots of efforts have been put so that this particular business will get more and more growth and more economic can be obtained. When we talk about the economic importance of the honeybee, the most important thing for doing this modern apiculture is for getting the pure type of honey. Whatever all the honey, its origin in certain plant material means whatever honeybees they are getting the nectar. So usually it is believed that whatever they are eating, so if they are making it from their own diet. So this chemical composition of honey is very much important. Major constituent when we talk about it contains water, fructose, glucose, sucrose, and other type of the sugar. Percent while if you will see 13.4 to 26.6% of water is present, then fructose 21.7% to 53.9%, glucose is 20.4 to 44.4%, sucrose may be 0 to 7.6, other sugar 0.1 to 16. This is about the sugar, but apart from that, it also contains the acid like gluconic 0.17 to 1.7%. It contains lots of minerals 0.02 to 1.03%, nitrogen in the form of protein 0.0 to 0.13. There are many enzymes present in the 0.1% approximate concentration, and aroma 0.1, and other HMF are also present. In short, the constituents are very much rich and very healthy for the consumption. So for that particular reason, honey is used in various purpose. Like many people, those who are avoiding the sugar, like diabetes people and all, they can take honey as means it is safe as compared to the normal sugar. So in cooking also, honey has been used. Honey drinks are made, honey beverages are made, honey is also used into the cosmetic because it improves the skin tone and also it feeds the muscle layer of the skin and that gives the glow on the skin. So for that particular reason, all its hygroscopic property, honey has been used in the various cosmetic purpose. Lots of vitamins like B1, B2, B3, B5, B6, vitamin C, vitamin E, vitamin K, as well as the carotene, all are present into the honey. So for that particular reason, it is used for curing many diseases like beriberi, anemia, pilagra, rickets, and scurvy. It is also used into the Ayurvedic and Unani system of medicine. Especially in Unani system, the base of many medicine is honey only. Herbal tea with honey, lemon juice with honey, old wives remedies, all such things they are using. Even when we talk about the homemade remedies, so definitely the honey plays a very important role there. Honey have lots of bactericidal properties. So for that they are using honey Even in Islam, honey have a very important place. Many places it is explained that honey can cure almost all disease. Honey inhibits the bacterial growth and it kills the bacteria like streptococci, staphylococci, typhoid bacillus, coliform bacteria, parathyroid bacterium A and B. When I got typhoid, I used to take honey twice in a day. And now also I don't prefer taking any type of the antibiotic. Any type of infection I am getting now, I have cough and cold from last 3 days, but I'm just taking honey and some home remedies, and now I am almost cured. Now, other than honey, honey wax is also very much important. This bee wax, approximate 40% of cosmetic are made with this bee wax only. Top quality bee wax price fetches about $4 to 10 per kilogram. Pure bee wax can be used for making the soap, good quality soap, shampoo, then skin ointment, skin cream, melting wax, and adding different type of oils, different type of perfume or color, and final products are made with the help of this bee wax. Even it is they have a very good print. You can see their design is very good, so they are used in a special type of print that is known as the batik. Then 30% of bee wax is used into the pharmaceutical industry. Propolis tincture, it is made up of the wax and 100% alcohol, that is vodka or grain alcohol. It can be used for curing any minor skin cut or abrasion. Propolis cream is medicinal soothing cream, which is made up of the bee wax, liquid paraffin, and the grain of the propolis and honey. It is used as a cosmetic cream. About 20% of the bee wax it is used for the purpose of the candle making. Bee wax candles do not smoke as candle made from the paraffin wax, and they have the best aroma as they burn very slowly, slowly, due to which people are willing to pay the high price for such type of the candle, and that can be used for the longer period of the time. Bee wax casting or carpido is process of metal casting that may be used to create the hollow and the solid metal item like jewelry and the ornaments. There are many other uses also. Approximate 20% of the bee wax is used for the purpose of the making car polish. The good quality polish of car is made up of such bee wax only. It is also make for using the polish for the furniture, shoe, and other leather product. It is also used into the lubricant for the industrial use. It is used as the insulation in electronic component into the computer industry. It is a sealant to make the air and waterproof sealing of bottle and container. It is also used in making drawing crayons. It is used for confectionery coating. It is used to strengthen the threads using into the darning, sieving, and kiting the flying, जिसको हम लोग मांझा बोलते हैं नॉर्मल लैंग्वेज में. इट इज ऑल्सो यूज फॉर प्रिपरेशन ऑफ द टिश्यू ब्लॉक्स इन टू द माइक्रोटोमी. माइक्रोटोमी इज अ टेक्निक वेयर द स्लाइड फॉर द टिश्यू कल्चर और हिस्टोलॉजी इज बीन यूज, एंड दैट पर्टिकुलर टाइम दैट दे आर एम्बेडिंग दैट टिश्यू इन टू द वैक्स. बट वेन वी आर यूजिंग द पैराफिन वैक्स, दैट ब्लॉक्स गेट ब्रेक वेरी इजिली. सो दैट पर्टिकुलर टाइम दिस बी वैक्स इज वेरी मच यूजफुल एंड दे सर्व दैट पर्पज इन अ वेरी बेटर वे. Apart from that, when we talk about the honeybee, so they are also very important. They are a very good pollinator. They help into the pollination of the plant, and also they detect the good environment. So if any changes into the environment, you can find the changes into the pattern of the honeybee. So this is all about the AP culture. Next lecture, we will be talking about the vermiculture, and thereafter we will be discussing the dairy culture in this unit. for this note, we'll stop now. If anyone have any doubt, can ask me.